That's it. Today's the day I'm asking Liam out. I don't care what happens next. Liam was my crush since middle school, and I couldn't just sit around anymore. I had to do something about my feelings. He was one of the cutest guys and was really popular with the teachers. He had loads of friends. Wait, I haven't introduced myself. My name is Emily. Growing up, I was really shy and never really had any friends. I was awkward and clumsy and no good at any sports. But the only thing that I loved was technology. I was fascinated by machines. That day, with my best outfit on, I built up my courage, and when I noticed he was alone by his locker, I walked over to him. "Hi, Liam," I said with a shy voice. I watched him raise an eyebrow and look at me before closing his locker. "And you are?" he asked. "Emily, we've been in the same class since middle school." "Oh," he said. "What can I help you with?" I stuttered. I wanted to ask you if maybe you wanted to go out for dinner or a movie or something? His eyes widened, and not in a good way. "Oh, well," he looked around nervously. I can't. I am very busy. You know, studying, football, and I gotta go." And just like that, he literally sprinted away from me. How stupid can I be? I was so foolish to think that he would go out with me. I watched him run away, and feeling totally bummed out, I started walking to my next class when I stepped on something. It was a small black notebook. I picked it up and opened it. On the first page, I saw his name. I had found Liam's secret diary. Should I run after him and give it back? Or should I keep it? I had the key to finding out more about him. I could find out what kind of girl he'd like and become that girl. I quickly slipped the diary in my backpack and ran to my next class. Throughout the day, all I could think of was what I would find in that little diary. I sat by my desk when I got home. I took a deep breath, made sure the door was closed, and opened the notebook. Liam's handwriting was not how I imagined it. It was very neat. I started with the first few pages. The entry started from when he joined our school a couple of years ago. I spent hours reading through. It was not as interesting as I expected. Stories about other girls, about football, stories about family and holidays, and regular stuff like that. However, some details kept showing up that made me think there was something more to this boy. Things like, "One of my toes fell out today, and I lost a screw. And I wish this was easier sometimes and things were back to normal," kept cropping up. What? It was all very confusing. I couldn't stop thinking about it for the next few days. Some of the things Liam had said about parts and screws just made me so curious, and I was coming up with all sorts of crazy theories. I needed answers to figure out Liam's big secret, and to get those, I had a spy on him. On Saturday evening, I decided to go to his house. Luckily, he lived in the same neighborhood. He was having a party that night, so I knew the house was empty except for him. Loud music was blaring from a room on the second floor, so I knew where to look. I found a gardener's ladder at the back of the house and set it up under Liam's room. I climbed up and looked through the window. There he was, standing by a mirror, unscrewing something on his left ankle. To my shock, his ankle just snapped out of place. He fixed it, walked over to his closet, and opened it. It was the craziest thing I had ever seen. There was a whole collection of lower body metal parts. Liam was a robot, at least partly. It was truly shocking. Liam's secret was bigger than I thought. I suddenly felt the ladder wobble under my weight, and before I could do anything, everything just spun out of control, and I found myself crashing onto the grass below. I cried out in pain. I looked up and saw Liam staring down at me, absolutely furious. He moved away from the window and within seconds was storming towards me. "You are such a creep. What are you doing here?" "Liam, I have your diary." I took out his notebook from my pocket. He snatched it, looking shocked and angry. "You had my diary and you read it, and now you're spying on me? Stay away from me." "Liam, I know your secret now," I said, "and honestly, I think it's pretty cool. I won't tell anyone, I swear." "Get out of my house now," Liam yelled. Defeated, I turned around and left as fast as I could. When I went to school the next day, there was a commotion. Around me, people were whispering, and what they said shocked me. "They say his legs are made of metal," a girl whispered. "Do you think it's true? They look human to me." I was really confused and shocked. Liam's secret was out. "You!" His voice was angry and deep, almost vicious. "You told everyone!" My eyes widened. I tried to explain and tell him that I didn't say anything. He walked furiously towards me and said, "You don't know what you did. I hate you." He blew out and left the school. I tried to contact him. I sent many messages apologizing. I wanted him to give me a chance to explain. It wasn't fair. But he never responded. As months passed, I could not get over that incident. I felt as if somehow I had betrayed Liam. I tried going out with other guys, but I couldn't stop thinking about Liam. I was never able to be with someone for more than a week because my heart was with Liam. The end of my senior year was not easy. Liam's secret was still the juiciest bit of gossip. and I felt haunted by it. Luckily for me, college came around sooner than I thought. I decided to major in robotics to keep my passion in technology alive. I could hardly believe my eyes when, upon entering my class, the first person I saw was Liam. I thought he had disappeared for good, but there he was, still looking as handsome as ever, and it was no surprise that he majored in robotics as well. I never tried to approach him or speak to him, and he always ignored me and always asked to change groups if we were paired together for projects. Part of him believed that it was me who had exposed him. I continued to keep my distance. Being so close to Liam every day was getting difficult for me. I started seeing this guy, Kevin, who was also in our class and had asked me out a few times. He seemed rather cocky, but I thought maybe I could get myself to like him if I tried hard enough. It was selfish of me, but maybe with him I could finally get over Liam and put him out of my life for good. It was Kevin's birthday and he wanted to throw a grand party. During the party, I think he wanted to brag to his friends that he had a girlfriend and kept me wrapped around his finger all night. I was really uncomfortable but didn't know what to do. I had enough. We were all dancing and he forcefully tried to kiss me. "What the hell do you think you are doing?" I yelled, pushing him away, and suddenly all eyes were on us. Kevin stared me down and I knew his look. It said, "You are embarrassing me." He let out a fake laugh and wrapped his arm around my shoulder, pulling me towards him roughly. "What, am I not allowed to kiss my girlfriend?" he asked, and his friends laughed with him. "Leave her alone, Kevin." I turned around in surprise to see Liam standing behind us. "What's your problem, dude? You're the one who kept asking me to ask Emily out." I was really confused when I heard that. Why would Liam do that? I saw him looking at me apologetically. Then he turned to Kevin. "That's before I knew you were such a prick. Now let go of her. You're clearly making her uncomfortable." Kevin stepped towards Liam angrily as if to punch him. But before he could do anything, Liam gave him a big shove into the pool behind him. Everyone gasped. I stood there in shock for a few seconds and then ran out of the party. "Emily!" Liam called out to me when we were outside. "What was all that about you asking Kevin to ask me out?" I said to him angrily. "I'm really sorry. I knew he was a bit of a jerk and I just wanted to get back at you for high school. I didn't know he would behave like this, though." "It wasn't even me who let your secret out in high school," I cried out with tears pouring down my cheeks. He looked at me for the first time as if he believed me. "It doesn't matter anymore. It's such a long time ago. I want to forget about that chapter in my life. I shouldn't have been so petty, Emily. I'm very sorry about Kevin, and I would really like to start over with you." I gave him a small smile, relieved that maybe he finally believed me and secretly happy that he wanted to even talk to me again. I had never stopped having feelings for him. It was difficult to face Kevin and the entire class after the party. However, I was more distracted by Liam and his sudden interest in me. I would find him staring at me during science class. I would find small notes with jokes on my desk from him. And when I read them, I realized he was looking at me, waiting for a smile or a laugh. Every football match, I would see his eyes raking the bleachers looking for me, especially with a big smile after every touchdown. Sometimes he would go out of his way to walk me to class and sometimes get me coffee before school. As months passed, Liam and I got really close. We eventually realized we were in love with each other and finally started dating. Liam was a box full of secrets, someone who just wanted to live a normal life like any guy his age. And I suppose I made him feel normal. We were the perfect couple. But just as things were going smoothly, his legs malfunctioned. It was the middle of the night, and the wires that connected his ankles to the rest of the body sparked, which soon turned into a mess. He woke up screaming. His brain could not understand what was happening. He couldn't feel anything or touch anything, and his limbs were out of control. I knew I could not take him to the hospital. He didn't want his secret out in the open. I had no other choice but to fix him myself. I tried to remember how to connect all the wires correctly. It was a difficult task, especially since I was trying to keep him in a calm state at the same time. To my surprise, Liam's wiring was familiar to me. It was simple, very similar to one of the computers. Finally, after a few hours, I managed to fix the issue. Suddenly, Liam broke down, sobbing like a little kid. "Are you still in pain, Liam?" I asked, feeling really worried. "No, I'm not, thanks to you, Emily. I think I'm finally ready to tell you why I am this way." He told me that one day when he was 13, he snuck out of the house in his parents' car and took his little brother along with him for a ride. They ended up in a terrible car accident. He underwent many surgeries, but the doctors could not save his legs. That's why he had the metal ones. His little brother, however, had passed away. He felt so terribly guilty. It was all his fault. His parents forgave him completely because he was just a little kid himself. They all moved to a new town to try to get a fresh start and leave that terrible memory behind. But Liam had never been able to get rid of the shame. He wanted to keep his past a secret, and that's why he never wanted anyone to know about the accident or his legs. When his secret came out in school, he just had to leave. I wanted to know my crush's secrets all those years ago, but I never imagined anything so tragic. I could understand now why he had reacted the way he did back in high school. I comforted him and hugged him to sleep. His secret was safe with me. One morning, I rolled over in bed to find Liam wasn't there. I went downstairs and looked around. Suddenly, I noticed a folded paper on the table with my name on it. I opened it up and felt a wave of shock going through me as I read it. I am going away for good. You're better off without someone like me. I will never be normal. I hope you find someone who really deserves you. Liam. How could this be happening? We had been so happy these past few days. We finally knew everything about each other. I tore up the note in despair. I had to find him and bring him back. For the next few weeks, I looked for him everywhere. I went absolutely crazy because I was madly in love with him. Liam was my life. I went to his parents' house. They had heard nothing from him in a while. I went to all of our friends. I went to every place we had ever hung out at. I was starting to lose my mind. I was wandering about the city at night like a madwoman, hoping desperately that I would bump into him in some dark alley, but it was no use. It was as if he had disappeared into thin air, leaving me completely heartbroken. One day, I woke up to find a note rolled up in a newspaper on the doorstep. It was from Liam. "Emily, stop looking for me and just move on with your life. I want you to be happy." He knew that I had been looking for him. That meant he had been spying on me all this time and knew what I was up to. This gave me an idea. Later that night, as I was walking down a street a few blocks from my house, a couple of thugs started following me. I broke into a run and they followed suit. One of them grabbed my bag while the other shoved me to the ground. Just as I was about to scream for help, I saw a tall, dark shadow behind the men. "Get away from her!" Liam shouted, running towards them. They immediately dropped my bag and ran off like scared little rabbits. Liam bent down next to me and took me in his arms. "Are you hurt?" I held on to him, sobbing. "I'm fine, Liam. I knew you would come if you thought I was in trouble." "Wait, what?" he asked. I explained to him that I had staged the whole thing. I knew he was spying on me, and the only way to make him turn up was to pretend that I was in danger. Liam shook his head, half amused and half angry. "So those goons are your friends? And I was thinking they ran away like that because of how scary I look," he said. "Oh, Liam, you can't ever leave me again. I thought I was going to go insane when I couldn't find you. I don't care if you're messed up. I can help you with your leg and I can help you deal with your past. Please don't break my heart. I can't live without you." My voice cracked as I tried to control my tears. "I thought things would be better for you if I went away," Liam replied, his eyes wet. "If I have to live without you, I'd rather not live at all." Liam pulled me close. "I can't survive without your love either. I thought I could, but I realized my mistake. I need you and want you in my life. Let's go home now." We have been living together for a year now, and Liam has made no attempt to escape again. I convinced him to see a therapist, and he has been feeling much better mentally. As for his leg, I'm pretty good at fixing him up.